Yo, what's up?
It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. Have you ever been working with a date table or a calendar table, then you join it to like a fact table, but the relationship doesn't seem to work? Well, if you have, this video is for you. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right. Dates. Adam called me up today and he said,
Patrick, my dates aren't working. I'm so frustrated. I tried everything. What am I missing?
All right. And so I asked him some questions. I said, Adam, the relationship right? He's like, really, Patrick? Data types match? He's like, really, Patrick? Mark is the date table? He's like, that doesn't even matter. I'm like, okay, man, just send me the PBIX file. Let me take a look. Adam knows. If you get my interest, I become obsessed and I won't stop until we figure it out. All right. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So he sent me this PBIX file and it was a really simple model. It had a calendar table and a fact table, and there's a relationship on the sales date to the date. And it was marked as a date table. That was the first thing I checked. And then I looked at the data types. I mean, the date in the calendar table was a date, and in the fact table was a date time. And I was like, well, let's switch it. So we switch it to a date. Now notice when I switch this to a date, nothing happens, it just switches. So let's see, I know this will work. There's my date from my calendar table, drop this in. Not working, there should be some dates here. What can I do? Let's go over here, make sure I change the data type. Yep, make sure the relationship is there. What am I missing? We had this conversation on our live stream and everybody was saying, if you change the data type in the desktop, in the model view, right, it's gonna flow back to Power Query. And I was always skeptical about that. So I called someone, my buddy, Matt Mason. And I said, Matt, is that true? He goes, no. Because when you load it up, it already does everything it needs to do. It's in memory and it's that data type. And I go, well, what does this do? He's like, you gotta call someone from the desktop team. And I had some conversation. It's like, it's really simple, right? The data types are stored in three ways, typically a floating point, an integer, or a string. And I was like, So then I had an idea. Let me show you. I'm gonna get rid of this and I'm gonna bring the date from the calendar table, put it in its own table. Then I'm gonna bring the date from the fact table, put it in its own table. And I'm gonna open up a notepad. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy the value from my calendar table, paste it in. This is from the cal. Then I'm gonna copy it from my fact table. Let's see what's up in here. Look at that. No time, sometime. Very interesting. Now it makes sense why they don't match up, why the columns are incompatible. Anyway, right, it makes sense. So how do I fix this? Well, you guys may be thinking the obvious, but I took a break and I went and took a shower. I went and took a shower, and in the shower I go, okay, Patrick, stop delaying the inevitable. You know how to fix this. Dried up, put some clothes on, I did shave, and then I came back down to my desk. And let me show you how I fix this. The obvious way how to fix this, let's delete all this out. Remember, I changed this from a date time to a date, and then I went home, and I went to transformation, and I verified that it didn't flow through. Let's take a look and see here. No additional step. I need to refresh my data, but you can see right there that is definitely a date time. What I did was I changed it to a date, just like that. Close and apply. It's gonna refresh up, and then I verified this, right? I dragged this and made a table, copied the value, really simple. Went over back to my notepad. Boom, no time now. So guess what? Let's delete this, drag the date from my calendar table, drop this in, boom. Now it works. If you truly want to change your data types, do it in Power Query. Probably oldie, simple, but something that we ran across and we thought, Adam and I thought it'd be a good video. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments? You got a better way? Am I missing something? You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. Your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. Like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.